We're here once again with our favorite automotive curmudgeon, Neil Mankin, the editor of Skin Knuckles magazine, has all kinds of tips on working on cars and how to do it economically. It looks like we're talking about fire extinguishers today,
Craig. We're going to talk about fire extinguishers, Jay. Okay. We spoke about this once before, mm-hmm. and there's a new item out that a guy should know about.
Okay.
First of all, a word of warning. If you have a car fire, first thing to do, very first thing, is get your passengers out of the car.
Right.
Second thing is call 911. Mm-hmm. Let the pros get on the way.
Right.
Then, if you have time, you can try to fight the fire yourself.
Okay.
But get 911 first.
See, I would think you'd grab the fire extinguisher first and then call 911.
If it gets out of hand.
Yeah, well, that's true.
You want those trucks on their way.
Because I'm thinking also in terms of garage fires as well.
Garage fires too.
You know, especially for old car guys, it's mostly garage fires rather than going down the road.
It's really a judgment call. Mm-hmm. If it's a small fire, it's very contained, you can try to fight it yourself. If there's a potential of it spreading,
yeah,
you want those big red trucks on their way.
Yeah, something too we should tell people, you know, this modern ethanol fuel, especially with older cars, you're seeing a lot more car fires now, right, because the ethanol eats the rubber. And you're going down the road, and then suddenly your fuel pump is squirting fuel on your exhaust manifold, and it leaks. And it's much more prevalent now than it's been in any other time, I think.
Oh, it's getting
yeah,
worse.
Yeah.
It's getting worse.
So that's why you always want to carry a fire extinguisher. Any car over 20 years old, carry one of these.
And you want it accessible. You don't want it buried in the trunk, under the spare tire, under the blanket, yeah, under the picnic stuff, under the carriage.
On one of my Duesenbergs once, I had a fire, and the guy had made me a beautiful leather cover to match the fire extinguisher, and he said it matched the interior of the car. And when it caught fire, it was right in front of me, I couldn't find it. I ran into a 7-Eleven, I just pulled sodas off and started squirting on the fire, and that's how I put it out. And then I went, where's my fire extinguisher? Oh, there it is. So have it where you can see it.
Most cars and most car owners they run into the discount store or big box store, and they buy a cheap fire extinguisher.
Right.
And most of them are dry chemical.
Right.
Good. It's a good fire extinguisher. It does a good job. But the big problem is it leaves a mess.
Yeah. And if you have a carburetor fire, it can ruin your engine too.
This is basically what the
what you're doing is you're putting essentially sand in your engine.
Well, it's bicarbonate of soda or some kind of soda. But it's a mess.
Yeah, yeah.
You'll never get it out of the car.
Right.
It'll get into the oil. It'll get into the crankcase. Well, one of the best fire extinguishers that can be used, it's clean, it's environmentally safe, there's no residue, and it knocks down that fire very, very quickly, is carbon dioxide.
Right.
It's basically the same stuff that we exhale when we breathe. So there's nothing harmful about it. The big problem with CO2 has always been it's a big, bulky fire extinguisher.
Right.
It's really too big for the car.
Right.
Well, Amarex has just come out with a new fire extinguisher. It's a 2.5-pound CO2, small enough to fit in the car. A mounting bracket is available to fit the fire extinguisher. It normally comes with a hook.
Right.
So in the garage, you can just put this on the wall, and the fire extinguisher will just hang there.
Right.
But for the car, you'd want to order the mounting bracket.
Is CO2 cheaper than halon?
Considerably cheaper than halon.
And halon is available again, correct?
Halon is still available. It's going to be available until, I think it's 2025.
Okay.
It's recycled halon. They cannot manufacture new halon.
Oh, okay.
But halon is available.
What is the cost to recharge one of these? About $10?
I don't know. I haven't had recharged, but it's when they come in and they do the shop, or they recharge these in the shop, it's a few dollars. It's very inexpensive. Yeah.
Now, I notice these don't have a gauge.
You don't need it. It's by weight.
Oh, I
see. These are by weight. Okay. CO2 is by weight.
I see.
Now, the old 5-pounders were steel containers.
Right.
The new ones are aluminum containers.
Right.
So they're much lighter.
Yeah.
All of the mechanisms are all metal.
Well, dumb question. Does this hold as much as that?
No, half as much.
Okay, so what's the thought? Okay.
2.5 pounds, and that's a 5-pound.
Okay.
This, I think, will give you about 9 seconds of firefighting.
Okay.
Everything is made in the USA.
Right.
Everything is made here. The only part that's not metal is the nozzle.
Right.
And the reason for that is CO2 puts out a fire in one of two ways. Number one, it cools the fire.
Mm-hmm.
When this comes out, it's cold.
Right.
Number two, it depletes the oxygen supply, so the fire doesn't have the oxygen it needs to burn.
Right, right.
Do me a favor, Jay. Try this.
Okay, just pull the pin out.
Pull the pin. Aim it and fire. There's no residue.
Right.
It's clean.
Right.
Everything gets very, very cold.
Right, that's cold.
One word of warning. Whenever you fire a fire extinguisher, whenever, whether it's for a test or anything else, it must be completely recharged.
Right, okay.
You can't just say, well, I just used it a little bit.
Right.
It has to be recharged because the valves inside and the O-rings inside can be contaminated.
Hey, dumb question. When you have a fire, are you better off a series of short bursts or just hold on it until the thing empties?
It depends on the fire. It depends on the extent of the fire.
Right.
You want to get as close as possible and not endanger yourself.
Okay.
And then do whatever you have to do to get that thing out.
So for car guys, you recommend CO2 or halon?
CO2 or halon.
Avoid the dry ones are probably the cheapest, aren't
they? They're absolutely the cheapest. You can find those in every discount store. Go to amorex-fire.com and they'll tell you where there's a local dealer that can supply this.
It's really important you keep a fire. I know guys that have had an old car and left the door open and the plastic dome light, being 50, 60 years old, it deteriorates. The heat from the bulb melts it. It catches fire. I knew a guy like that, lost his whole garage. Yep. Just based on that, left the door open.
Yep. Yeah. All you need is something just to give it a shot.
Right, there you go.
Give it a shot.
There you are. Neil, thank you very much.
Jay, thank you. Mm-hmm.